Hello everyone, welcome back. First of all, I would like to inform you that I have revised the name of the channel, so it is now Chemical Engineering and Aspen channel. The purpose of changing the name of the channel is to cover the chemical engineering aspects along with the Aspen concepts. So in our lecture series on the topic of chemical reaction engineering, we are bringing the lecture number 8 for our valuable viewers. By the end of this lecture, we will be able to finish the chapter number 2 of the book Elements of Chemical Reaction Engineering by H. Scott Fogler. So in our today's course coverage, we will first solve an example related to reactors in series. At the end of this example, we will compare the isothermal and adiabatic reactors based on the real-time data. And finally, we will see the space-time and space-volume concepts, and we will solve an example related to it. So let's solve an example. Calculate the volume of each of the three reactors for an entering molar flow rate of n-butane of 50 kmol per hour. The reaction that takes place that normal butane converts to isobutane in a reversible system. For each conversion, the rate of reaction is given. Now, if you see this diagram, there are three reactors in the system. Two are CSTR, first and third, and the second one is PFR. FA0 is entering the CSTR. The CSTR has volume V1, and the rate of reaction takes place is designated as RA1. Here it is V2 volume with rate of reaction as RA2, and similarly V3 and RA3. In first reactor, we get conversion of 20%. By the end of second reactor, we get an overall conversion of 60%. By the end of third reactor, we get an overall conversion of 65%. So now we have been given that FA0 is 50 kmol per hour. So X is given, minus RA is given. Dividing FA0 over minus RA will give an answer as 1.28, 0.94. We have simply divided 50 by this 39, 53, 59, 38, and 25, and accordingly we have got these answers. So for the CSTR1, for which the conversion is 0.2, V1 is equal to FA0 X1 minus X0 over minus RA1, or that is equal to FA0 over minus RA1 X1. If you remember our previous lecture, we have solved these equations. So FA0 over minus RA1 at 20% conversion is 0.94 multiplied by 0.2, so that gives an answer of 0.188 cubic meters. For PFR, where we got the conversion of 60%, obviously initially 20% conversion takes place in the CSTR. So our starting point or the X0 will be 0.2 and the ending point will be 0.6. So V2 is equal to integral 0.2 to 0.6 FA0 over minus RA dx. Applying the Simpson 1/3 rule, delta x over 3 FA0 over minus RA at x is equal to 0.2 plus 4 times FA0 over minus RA at x is equal to 0.4 plus FA0 over minus RA at x is equal to 0.6. So delta x, obviously it is 0.2, because 0.6 minus 0.2 divided by 2 will give an answer of 0.2. 0.2 divided by 3, this value at 0.2 is 0.94, 4 multiplied by 0.85 and 1.32. So accordingly, PFR answer is 0.38 cubic meter. Finally, solving for the remaining conversion from 60 to 65%, it means X3 will be 0.65, X2 will be 0.6. FA0 over minus RA3 at 65% conversion is 2. X3 minus X2, 0.65 minus 0.6 will be 0.1 cubic meter. So this is the overall procedure to solve reactors in series. Now, if you see here, the first volume is 0.188 cubic meter. And you can see here that if we have placed PFR first, then volume of PFR would be higher because of the fact that this area would have been covered as well. Similarly, if you look here, obviously the CSTR volume would be higher because this region would also have been covered, as we have discussed earlier as well. And similarly, for the last part, which is 0.1 cubic meter, the CSTR volume is higher than PFR because this is the extra part that is coming out of this curve. Now, we will compare the reactor volumes. There are two combinations. You can see, first one, this shows the isothermal system, and we have installed CSTR here and we have installed PFR over here, and you can see easily, and we have solved an example related to it, that the volume was 6.4 cubic decimeter while that of PFR was 2.2 cubic decimeter. So obviously for the isothermal system, it was simple that volume of CSTR will be greater than the volume of PFR for the same conversion, for the same flow rate as well. But if you look here, for the adiabatic system, in this region, you can see the volume is 0.188 cubic meter. While for the PFR, the answer would have been 0.207 cubic meter. It means that for adiabatic system, the CSTR may require a smaller volume than the PFR to achieve the required conversion. Now, you have been given the two cases. First one is that first CSTR is installed, then PFR is installed. Here, PFR is first installed and then CSTR is installed. So now you can imagine, based on the previous knowledge, before I show you the answer, that which of the combination would be better. Just discussing it, that this area is empty over here. The system is not coming out of this curve. While here, this is an extra part in comparison to this. And probably this one is also an extra part. So it means here the volume will be higher. Here the volume will be lower. So accordingly, this one will be the best arrangement, while this one will be the worst arrangement in terms of reactors in series. So now, which arrangement is best? In the same way, for this isothermal system, obviously we know that probably this one will be the best, because it will always remain as area under the curve. But for the adiabatic system, which one will be the best? It will be decided by the intervals, that what will be the x1 and what will be the x2 or x3 or x4. We cannot simply say that PFR is best or CSTR is best. We have seen that in some regions CSTR was best, in some regions PFR was best. So that concludes our topic on reactors in series. Moving on to the last part, the space time. What is the space time actually? It is the time which is required to process one reactor volume of fluid based on the entrance conditions, or it is specified as the holding time or mean residence time. Its definition is space time is equal to volume over volumetric flow rate. So volume unit is cubic meter, volumetric flow rate is cubic meter per time, cubic meter is cancelled out with cubic meter, units will be time, or it is time required to process one reactor volume of feed measured at the specified condition. If we get an answer of 2 minutes, what does that mean? That every 2 minutes, one reactor volume of feed at specified conditions is being treated by the reactor. That after 2 minutes, new batch will come, 4 minutes, second batch will come. It means that one reactor batch or one reactor volume is processed in the 2 minutes, or it is said as V over V naught is equal to tau. Now for the PFR, V is equal to FA naught integral 0 to x dx over minus RA over V naught. So this term will become as CA naught. CA naught integral 0 to x dx over minus RA, that is equal to tau for the PFR system. And obviously in the similar lines, it will be for the CSTR system. Now you can see that, for example, we designate the starting point as A and ending point as B. And the total length of this PFR is 20 meters. So the time it takes for the fluid to enter. Now, for example, it has entered as 0 minute and it has left here at 2 minutes. So the total which this fluid has spent into this reactor will be the residence time or space time. The time it takes for this fluid to enter the reactor completely is the space time. For example, if the volumetric flow rate was 0.01 cubic meter per second and the volume was 0.2 cubic meter, so the total residence time will be 20 seconds, or we can say that it takes 20 seconds for the fluid to move from point A to point B. This is the overall concept of the space time, or we can simply specify it as the ratio of volume of the reactor to the volumetric flow rate of the fluid. For batch system, the value of tau is higher, 15 minutes to 20 hours, and the production capacity is obviously low because you have more residence time, more holding time in the reactor, few kg per day to some thousand tons per year. For CSTR, 10 minutes to 4 hours, and you can see the production capacity has increased. For tubular reactor, it is 0.5 second to 1 hour. So you can see the production capacity has increased significantly. Finally, the space velocity concept, it is the reciprocal of the space time. Like the number of reactor volumes of feed at specified condition, which can be treated in a unit volume, V naught over capital V. Now its unit will be per time. The units of space time were time. So 1 over time will be time inverse. A space velocity of 5 per hour means that 5 reactor volumes of feed at specified condition are being fed into the reactor per hour. A space time of 1 hour means that the fluid has spent 1 hour in the reactor, or it has moved from point A to point B. But once it goes to per hour, it means that these reactor volumes have been processed per hour. For example, it is 2 per hour, it means 2 reactor volumes. If it is 10 per hour, it means 10 reactor volumes have been processed per time. We see the difference in space velocity and space time. The space velocity is measured at some different conditions, while space time is measured at the entrance conditions. Now, space velocity is measured as different conditions. What are these conditions? Liquid hourly space velocity and gas hourly space velocity. For the liquid hour space velocity, we say that this space velocity is measured as that of the liquid at 60 or 75 degree Fahrenheit, even though the feed may be a vapor at some higher temperature. So we will take the standard conditions for that. For gas hourly space velocity, it is measured at standard temperature and pressure, which we say it as STP. So V naught of liquid over V, that will be LHSV, liquid hourly space velocity, while GHSV, gas hourly space velocity, is V naught, which is the volumetric flow rate at standard temperature pressure. And finally, solving the example, we have tau is equal to V over V naught. V naught is 0.002 cubic meter per second. The volume was 6.4 cubic meter, as we have seen in the case of CSTR. So the space time is 0.89 hour, and the reciprocal of it is 1.125 per hour. It means that 1.125 reactor volume is processed per hour in CSTR, or 0.89 hour is required for the fluid to move from point A to point B. For PFR, we calculated the volume as 2.165. So 2.165 cubic meter divided by 0.002 cubic meter per second. So it is 1083 second, or 0.3 hour. You can see it has reduced from 0.89 to 0.3 hour. And accordingly, space velocity has increased to 3.3 per hour. It means that 3.3 reactor volumes could be processed in 1 hour. You can see it has almost tripled as compared to the CSTR. That's why we say that PFR are more suitable to deal the higher capacities as compared to the other reactors in the system. So that concludes our chapter number 2. I hope you have liked this video, you have understood the concept. If you have any suggestion, comment, query, please provide your suggestion in the comment box and I will be happy to answer these. So that's it from this video. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos.